Good evening and welcome to tonight's show from DJN TV, Disc Jockey News TV. Tonight's show is brought to you by Electra Voice, DJ Event Planner, DJ Trivia, Odyssey Innovative Designs and Cases, NLFX Professional, Promo Only, and the DJN TV Insiders.
DJ Event Planner will change the way you manage and run your business. Streamline all of your procedures and software into one easy-to-manage system. DJ Event Planner, the ultimate online planning tool.
It's time for Tuesday Night Live Chat with Brian S. Red and John Young. So, Brian, I was wondering, you know, in the fall, it's such a lovely time, and it's a great time to get together with friends. And I was just wondering, would you be available maybe early November for us to maybe have a hangout together with some of our DJ friends?
Why, yes, John, I will be. However, it's not fall yet.
Oh, that's true.
We got another month of summer, so let's just enjoy it. But yes, in November, I will be available.
We will be available, and we'll be talking about that in a little bit later in tonight's show. If those of you who'd like to come and hang out with us, we'll be over on the East Coast in November, and we'll be getting to that. Plus, for those of you on the West side of the country, we've got something coming up for you also. A lot of cool things. Tonight, we're going to be talking about, we're going to start the night off, talking about one-hit wonders, and some of them that still hit or still work on our dance floor tonight. This is something actually from Reggie. Reggie's like, have you guys ever done a show on one-hit wonders?
I think so.
And it's like, Reggie, you know how many times Brian and I referred to one-hit wonders? Do you know, in all the shows that we've done, I went through and did the search, we have not had a specific one-hit wonder show.
Okay.
Let's
do one tonight. I didn't prepare, but I don't think it matters.
Yeah, I was going to say, would it really, really matter? So,
oh, man.
And this is where we want to have those of you out in a shadow on my face. Where, ooh, there's a wire.
The shadow's all over my face.
Okay, I'm just going to pull as I'm bouncing back and forth. So, okay, I think we're better. So for those of you out in the chat world, whether you're on Facebook or YouTube or anywhere out there, we should be able to follow the chat. And what I want you guys to do is toss out, we want to try to differentiate between good one-hit wonders and the one-hit wonders that are good and still work today. Some of them are good and maybe cocktail, but there's some that still work on our dance floor today. So we are going to kind of dig into that for that area. So Brian, for those people who are younger or haven't experienced it, one-hit wonder, how would you define that?
Well, I always look at it from the perspective of the U.S. So there are acts out there that have multiple hits, like let's say in England or something, but only one hit happened here. I still consider them a one-hit wonder. It's somebody who had a hit, but we never really heard much else from them. They may have had a follow-up that didn't do much, or maybe they were, you know, big in Japan or something, but we really didn't hear anything else from them here. We got one big tune, and that was it. But they could be rock stars other places in the world. So, you know, there's a lot of that.
So give us an example of someone, a one-hit wonder that hit in the U.S. with one, and yet were well-known in other parts of the world.
Madness would be one that would come to mind with Our House. We would consider them a one-hit wonder in America. But in England, they had hits for 15 years. That was just one of their songs.
So tonight, we're going to do this for you, and this is going to screw up our YouTube, but, you know, who cares?
We don't
care tonight.
It may not screw up our YouTube. They've been pretty cool about it lately.
They might. They'll probably let it still slide. So madness from our house. The one that just jumped to mind, and I think we've talked about Gary Glitter before. Wasn't Gary Gary Glitter one that that was also?
Yeah, but we try not to talk about him much because I guess he did really naughty things. But
yeah, but yeah. He, I mean, he fits that.
He had Rock and Roll Part One, which was like a sports anthem for a long time. But in Europe, again, many, many hits. He was a glam rocker.
And the one that we know is the Rock and Roll Part Two.
Part Two? Part One, I don't know.
Well, there is a Part One. So does the Part One have... It has lyrics. I would have never...
Part Two is just the...
The Part Two is the one that we've known and play.
Okay.
So let's look at some of the some of the chat room here as we're going on.
Morales is mentioning True by Spandau Ballet, and that's another one. They had a slew of hits over in England and probably Europe as well, but we got True. But they had some really good ones over there. There's one called, I think it's, is it Number Nine Chant, Can't Keep This Pressure On, or something like that. They had one called Gold that was really big, but we never got any of that. All we got was True, which is a nice song.
Mm-hmm. And this is one that I play pretty much, generally almost at every wedding, I think.
Yeah.
Somebody mentioned Dexie Midnight Runner. Who did that?
Yeah, they had an album, and I think they had a minor hit with a track called, I think it was called Celtic Soul Brothers.
Oh, yeah, I remember. I remember that. Something like that, yeah.
For the most part, yeah, I would call it that. Jimmy Spin is mentioning Safety Dancemen Without Hats. That's a Canadian act, and they had a minor hit years later with a song called Pop Goes to the World, but they're still in the U.S. very much considered a one-hit wonder with Safety Dancemen.
Yeah, Pop Goes to the World. I remember when that came out, and we thought, oh, this is going to be cool because, you know, and it had airtime during that period of time.
It got video airplay. Yes. I don't know that it got
much
airplay. I remember seeing it on MTV or something.
Oh, let's see. Did I miss any so far?
But I wouldn't consider it a hit, you know. But you could definitely play Safety Dance. So you're naming all kinds of them.
Yeah, Jimmy mentions, we're going to go through and try to do as many of these and give you a little sample. For those of you who have never heard some of these, that's what we're trying to do tonight. So if this gets blocked, I'm sorry. It wouldn't be our first time, and it won't be our last time. We may be, at some point in time, the Facebook one might be go, bloop, it's done that before. Oops, not that one. I wanted to go to Wild Cherries, Play That Funky Music. I don't even...
Yeah. I don't know that they had another hit at all.
I think that was the one and only there. Let's see. Come On, Eileen.
Dexie's Midnight Runners. Yep. Good one. Still played a lot. I play that one an awful lot. And it works.
Dave, now, Dave, is Dave being Canadian tonight?
I don't know. But somebody's mentioning Brown Eyed Girl. No, Van Morrison was not a one-hit wonder.
Van Morrison
had a slew of hits.
Oh, yeah, just a ton.
Brown Eyed Girl was the one that mobile DJs know. And there were a lot of other ones.
Yeah, and you
Moon
go to
Dance, Jackie Wilson Sing.
Have I Told You Lately?
Have I Told You Lately? Yeah, there's a bunch of Van Morrison hits. So that totally does not count.
In a big country, Canadian group.
Yeah.
This would be one that, while it's a cool song and I play it during dinner, that 80s cocktail time, yeah, certainly not a dance floor.
They were doing three-wheelers in the video. I remember that. That was kind of cool.
Howie says 5 seconds or less. Challenge accepted. We're going to try it.
Aaliyah, Donnie Iris. Yeah. Well, no, Donnie Iris had another track that was a hit. I think it was called Love Is Like a Rock. And that was a FM rock station hit.
Where are you at?
Howie Darkstar is talking about Aaliyah by Donnie Iris.
Yeah, where is he at? I'm trying to find that in the chat. And the problem is I'm looking at a different chat. I'm looking at the chat that has everybody. So Howie might be down. Oh, there it is, way down there. Oh, he's way down there. So I've got I'm still back up here by Mickey here.
Huh.
From Tony Basil. Which of course that's what Tony Basil didn't do a second. Was there anything?
No, she was a choreographer. I think she still is a choreographer. She did a lot of work with other artists for their videos and such, but I don't believe she had another hit.
So she has Mickey and she has Hey Mickey. Oh, but then she's got Street Beat. What does Street Beat sound like?
It was probably the B side. I got nothing on that.
Yeah, I got nothing on
that. Now, this is not to say they never tried to have another hit again.
Yeah, it just didn't happen.
It's to say that they never had another hit. They could have multiple albums out there, but one hit. That is something that happens.
Right Said Fred is probably one of these songs that it was so played. Some of these songs, we maybe kind of played them when they first came out, maybe kind of, or didn't, but they seem to come back later. Safety Dance is almost more popular today than it was when it came out.
Yeah, yeah, and we've talked about that before, where it's one of my daughter's favorite songs from the 80s, and I think she thinks we were all doing the Safety Dance in 1983.
We were walking to school every morning, and we were doing...
It happened for 5 minutes, and it was over, and the rest of the time, we were doing Hungry Like the Wolf over and over again, and Billy Idol's Rebel Yell, or whatever else was out.
So Right Said Fred, though, where I was headed with that is that
they had another hit called Don't Talk, Just Kiss.
I don't remember
it wasn't that. As major as I'm Too Sexy, but it was indeed, it was on the dance charts anyway, because I heard a lot in the clubs.
Yeah, and it didn't even pop up in the first 10 things with doing a search for them on YouTube.
And they had an absolutely hilarious song, probably I want to say about 15 years ago, called You're My Mate, that was a hit in the UK. I thought it was funny.
Well, you know, they were big enough that they have Right Said Fred the hits. So
yeah, also a Proclaimers the hits, but there's nothing on there anybody wants to hear.
So yeah, let's look at the popularity. Stand Up for the Champions is like half the bar, and then I'm Too Sexy has got a full bar, and then there's nothing. Nothing.
Well, yeah, but that's US.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Oh, we got Dennis Falcone in the house, man. Dennis Falcone, he's actually a program director on Sirius XM, and he's watching tonight, and he throws out the Outfield with Your Love, and he's absolutely right. That is definitely a one-hit wonder, the Outfield. They had another song, though, Dennis, All the Love in the World. You remember that one? And it was a minor hit. It did get airplay.
This was another one at that point. They had a couple. Say It Isn't So was another song.
I don't remember that one.
Yeah, that one received. What's that?
It was one called All the Love in the World. That actually did chart.
Here we go.
Yeah.
Yeah, The Outfield.
Remember that one?
Oh yeah, yep. I think I had the album.
Of course you did.
So you know that was
game free with Huey Lewis the News of Sports.
Exactly. Every time you bought a Huey album, you got an Outfield or you got a Cars album. It was great.
Right.
Let's see, The Proclaimers.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, they definitely hit fit into that. But this one was actually another one that, when it came out, we played this snot out of it compared to some there.
I still play this one. I didn't for a long time, but I started playing it again.
Now this...
I don't know, a few years ago.
The Barbie Girl one. This is another one I think I play more today than I did when it came out.
Yeah.
Did I explain it? Couldn't tell you.
Joe's talking about Tub Thumping by Chumbawamba. They actually had one, what was it called? I can't remember what it was called, Long-Term Memory Loss or Brain Damage, but they did have another follow-up track to that was actually kind of good. Was it called Long-Term Memory Loss?
I'm just going to go search Amnesia.
Amnesia, that's the one. Yeah, that was kind of good.
I don't know if I ever heard that one. I don't remember.
Yeah, do you suffer from long-term memory loss? I can't remember. Yeah.
Oh, yes. Okay, I remember the hook.
Yeah, the hook. It was pretty good.
Yeah, I remember the hook there. D-Light Groove Is in the Heart, just bouncing through some of them. I'm a little behind.
Yeah, wow. You know, probably. But yeah, I will say that the entire World Click album is golden. That album is so good. And the B-side to Groove Is in the Heart is a track called What Is Love? And that was a club hit. And it was really good. So I guess technically they were a one-hit wonder, but that whole album is front to back really, really good.
Okay, so we got to go to the Donny Iris. I'm finally caught up there.
Now, Aaliyah.
Yes, I have heard that one before.
Okay, but his follow-up was called Love Is Like a Rock, and it was really good. And I think I could see us actually playing that at the right mobile event. Like, if you were doing a Class of 82 reunion, you could probably play Love Is Like a Rock, because it's like an anthem-sounding song.
Just getting things set up here.
It kind of has that, it's like an up-tempo version of The Stroke or something. I don't know how to describe it.
What was the song again? I'm sorry. Another one from Donny Iris.
The other one from Donny Iris, Love Is Like a Rock.
Okay, let's pop one up here.
I think that's the name of it.
Yep, Love Is Like a Rock.
Kind of a neat song.
Huh. I don't think I've ever heard that one.
We'll rock you. Da, na, na, na. It's kind of a good one.
Huh. I like that one. It's a different one. Moondance is a great album. Hooters and We Dance. Oh, I like that tune.
Yeah, that was, I think, yeah. I don't think the Hooters did anything else. How he's talking about Mexican Radio, Wall of Voodoo.
Marky Mark, Good Vibrations. Oh, Jimmy, there's so many great songs that Marky Mark did.
Actually, that was somebody else. Never mind. There was another Marky Mark track that I'm not familiar with, but somebody pointed out to me recently. But yeah, Good Vibrations is the only one I remember.
Yeah, there was what was the second one? It came off that same Music for the People. I thought.
Huh?
Wild Side.
Oh, yeah. We've got some really good ones in the chat room.
Yeah, that's why I like these nights, is when people could throw stuff out at us. And
participating. Some of them are not one-hit wonders. Somebody said Pretty Fly for a White Guy. And that was Offspring, and they had Come Out and Play was their first hit.
Exactly, yeah.
And then they had another one, something about Go Get a Job or something like that. There was several hits from off of that particular album. Nina, 99 Love Balloons. To my knowledge, yes, only one-hit wonder in America. That was their only track.
You're way ahead of me. Take on Me. And this, I don't understand why this one is so popular with the younger people, like at weddings. I think this showed up on 4 or 5 of my weddings this summer.
It was probably an Adam Sandler movie or something. I don't know. Some Netflix Adam Sandler movie was like the title track or something. It's always something stupid like that.
Casey came back with Tommy Two Tone.
Emerald.
I think he's almost a poster child.
That was a one-hit wonder for him, absolutely.
Tommy Two Tone. Great.
David Marez is saying, I just want to stop Gino Vannelli.
Ooh,
no,
yeah.
Gino Vannelli had other hits.
Good song.
Talked about this.
Yep.
It's a great song, but the first one was People Gotta Move from like 74. And then there was one that you really liked in the mid-80s, right, Sean?
Yep.
What was it called?
Wild Horses.
Wild Horses, yeah.
I just want to see if I can pop it up. So, Gino Vannelli, Living Inside Myself.
Yes, that was big too. That's right.
Yeah, that was and then I Just Want to Stop.
Turn.
And Wild Horses doesn't even make the front.
No, that's a terrible song. That's why. They're throwing these at us like crazy, man. We're getting so many really good.
Oh, come on.
Suggestions.
Seriously, I'm going to find that song so I can play it, because come on. No! They don't even have it on
Guess the only place they heard it was in Grey Eagle.
No, here we go. Hang on. Okay. We've got a video version. Come on.
Oh, Butterfly Crazy Town. I got a soft spot for that track.
Oh my gosh, it's a video and it's so quiet. I'm so sad now.
Sorry.
Okay.
Yeah, Bow Wow Wow, I Want Candy. There might have been another Bow Wow Wow song, but I don't remember it. That was kind of underground stuff when it came out.
Yeah,
Malcolm McLaren punk rock kind of, or post-punk stuff that he was doing.
Oh, we got it. Michael.
Yeah, I would count that as a one-hit wonder.
It would, but I didn't know this song existed until I saw it on a DJ compilation. It's like, really?
Oh, yeah. And this was scandalous, too, because the girl who, the singer, posed nude on the album cover, and she was like 14. And this was a Malcolm McLaren production, so I don't know.
Okay,
somehow he got away with it.
Michael mentions the Tubes. Come on, dude. One in a Million Girl. You know,
there were other Tube songs.
This is that. She's a Beauty. And then there was Talk to You Later.
Yes, that was a big one.
This is big.
Yes.
Oh, there's a couple. There's a couple more. Where are they?
Something about Come On You Sports Fans or something.
Oh, there's was the compilation Backwards Principle. The Attack of the 50-Foot Woman.
Okay.
I'm sorry. This is another one of them where I had the album, so I listened to the whole thing.
Jimmy's talking about Stereo MC's Connected. They had another track called Ground Level that was on the same album that actually got airplay. Stardust Music Sounds Better With You. You know what, Joe? You're kind of right.
Okay, so hang on. Stereo MC's had this is a big Connected here. That's a good tune.
Yeah, but they also had one called Ground Level that was really good.
Ground Level. Oh, I'm not seeing it. It definitely doesn't show up on the first page. Huh.
Stardust Music Sounds Better With You was kind of half of Daft Punk. So, yes and no. I have no idea what Reggie's talking about. Paul McCartus, boom, boom, boom. Let's go back to
Michael Buffer 2 Unlimited is Jock Jam.
What was the 2 Unlimited? Because there were multiple 2 Unlimited
songs.
Yeah,
but this is the Jock Jam is what he's... the actual Ooh. The Jock Jam, where is it? Oh, they may not even have it on iTunes.
Oh, you're talking about Bobby D doing the medley.
Yeah.
Bobby D was a monster DJ on B96 in Chicago. He did a lot of mixes. That one was just a hit. And he mixed those Jock Jams things. White Punks on Dope, the Tubes. Yeah, Matchbox 20 has a lot of songs. I got to scroll up because guys are really hammerous.
I'm way behind.
And since there's so many people here in the chat, go ahead and like the video. So I don't know.
Yeah, Jay Brandon pointing out Little Red Corvette. Yes, that would be the one.
Yes,
and
Prince's only hit right there.
Yeah, there was nothing else that the guy barely had much for skills.
Mexican Radio Wall of Voodoo. I think I had that going through Howie's head on repeat for a while. I'm just scrolling up. Yeah. Dave Clevenger is talking about "So Alive" by Love and Rockets.
Ooh,
yeah, that was their only top 40 hit, but I think Love and Rockets did pretty well in the alternative music circles, and they had several songs. But that was their hit, kind of like Susie and the Banshees with Peekaboo. But there were a lot of Susie the Banshee songs that hit on alternative charts and dance charts and things. Or Ministry with "Every Day Is Halloween." I mean. Yeah, that was a hit for Ministry, but they had a lot of club hits, a lot of underground hits, and things as well. So,
see, I wish iTunes would be a little bit better, because if you're not exactly sure how they spell, there we go. No, didn't tell them to get it. Sorry. Okay.
Dead or Alive had Brand New Lover. Yeah, but Dead or Alive, well, they had a lot of songs. Dead or Alive was... In Too Deep was a big one.
We're going to go there. We're going there. So this is the one... This is the one I think that...
Something in My House.
This is the one that Michael put on there. Was You Spin Me Round Like a Record. And then Brand New Lover was another
one. Yeah. Something in My House was another one. It was big.
Yeah, we got to go to the album. Because that particular album, I think, had...
On Mad, Bad, and Dangerous to Know. Side 2. First spot.
Come on. My Heart Goes Bang, I think, was one.
Yes. In Too Deep was another one.
Yeah, they had a few.
Big Daddy the Rhythm, my favorite, but that was like a club hit, like a gay club hit, but I like that song. And they had one called Come Home With Me Baby. Yeah, a lot of hits.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's some good stuff. Okay, there's the Cotton Eye Joe from the Rednecks.
I'd call that a one-hit wonder in America, absolutely.
Let's see if there's anything. Yeah, that's the only thing Rednecks. I mean, there are other songs, but that's the only one that's showing up here.
Somebody said, I think we're alone now, Tiffany. I think she had other hits, but I
oh yes,
can't remember yes. what the hell they were.
We'll find some of those Tiffany hits right here.
Because Tiffany and Debbie Gibson kind of...
I think
kinda...
We're Alone Now was the big one, and a lot of people know. But the one that I played most of the time was I Saw Him Standing There.
Oh, yeah, the remake of that song.
Because this one we could play, and anyone who was a little bit older at that time remembered the Beatles version, and it was...
Right.
And this was the sassy little gal singing it. It worked really, really well. Those are basically the two that we used.
David comes up. I forgot about this track, Naked Eye by Luscious Jackson. Yeah, that's a one-hit wonder. Sugar Ray had more than one song, though. Fly wasn't their only track. They had one called Someday that was really good, too.
They had a few of them. Luscious Jackson, we're going to do that one.
Yeah, I like that one. It's good.
Huh. I don't even know this one.
What's a good song? You probably know the hook. When you hear the hook, you'll know it. I like that one. I forgot about that track. It was kind of an oasis in the crappy 90s. Yeah. Kind of like with Garbage Did Stupid Girl. I kind of like that song too. Luscious Jackson was kind of like that.
Okay, so...
Rock On, Michael Damian. Only in America. Michael Damian had other things going on in England and Australia.
So
specifically with Kylie Minogue, and I'm a little jealous, so I just don't want to talk about that. A little sensitive about that one.
Yeah, that's the... I don't know. That would have not been the song I would have thought it was.
Hanson had more than one hit. Where Is the Love was another big hit Hanson had.
Okay, so somebody, you just mentioned one that had...
Mary Jane Girls in My House. I don't recall another hit from Mary Jane Girls. All Night Long was a hit from Mary Jane Girls. So I do recall another hit from Mary Jane Girls. But I love In My House. It's one of my favorite songs. It's so good. Angel Shaggy. No, it wasn't me was Shaggy. Mr. Loverman was Shaggy. Oh, yeah, there were a lot of Shaggy songs.
The Rembrandts one. Someone.
I'll Brian, remember you.
Brian,
yeah,
remember. That's certainly one hit wonder, but Dan Carpenter, the other night when he and I were talking about wedding songs, and he talked about sometimes dropping these theme songs. Specifically, he mentioned this and Fresh Prince. And people singing along and
sure
doing their thing. So
I can't keep track of all of the things they're saying in
Ice Baby. Well, that
no,
there's
play that funky music, White Boy.
Oh, there's a couple of really big hits out there from Vanilla Ice. Play that funky music. Where was there was another one he did that was just like so bad.
Oh, he did a lot of them that were really bad.
That was really, really bad. Oh, play that.
What's up, Four Non Blondes? Yeah, I'll give you that one. Patrick Swayze, She's Like the Wind. All right. Yes. It's like saying, oh, yeah, and Don Johnson's Heartbeat. Let's just add that one to the pile, too. Crockett from Miami Vice had a song.
That's right, he did. Heard.
And Bruce Willis, Respect Yourself. We'll put him in the pile while we're at it, too. 80s movie guys doing songs.
Yes.
Damn, there's
Don Johnson. And let's go to the Bruce Willis. There's actually a couple that he
Respect
did.
Respect Yourself was his big one.
But his version of Under the Boardwalk was actually not too bad.
Okay.
But Respect Yourself was his...
That was his hit. Oh, Seal had hits. Seal had hits with the Damski, and Seal had hits otherwise. So, no, Kiss My Rose is not a one-hit wonder.
Okay. Okay, so I get the chat, Brian, from all of the things are coming into this one chat, and I'm scrolling down a page. I'm not even halfway down that chat.
Howie says, incense and peppermint strawberry alarm clock. I never occurred to me that they were a one-hit wonder, but I bet they were. I'm like, because I can't recall another strawberry alarm clock song. And I think it's been enough years where we're probably, you know, safe to say they're not going to have another hit.
Strawberry alarm clock. Okay, I'm going to look this. Now, what was the song?
Incense and peppermints.
Oh, yeah. Wow.
I believe they were a one-hit wonder, Howie. Yeah, Seal had a bunch. A lot of Miles, Black Velvet. Yep. Oh, yeah, Marcy Playground, Sex and Candy. Dave Clevenger throws that one in.
Okay, we got to play Black Velvet because...
Okay, DJ Brian K says, just wanted to say I'm really enjoying the show tonight. Not just not chiming in. Well, I'll chime in for Brian because I know one of Brian's favorite songs was a song that really didn't have a band that really didn't have hits in the U.S., but they had a hit with one track.
Uh-huh.
They had minor hits, I guess, in the late 60s, early 70s, but not big hits. Slade with Runaway.
Yes.
Brian Keith's like favorite song.
We got to play this one because this was to
find. We can actually play this as a DJ.
We had to go and get a UK export. This is the first time I bought a CD from an international CD to get this particular track.
Almost. Now they are icons in England.
Yeah, this is.
But here, this was their song.
So this particular track is one that got us gigs back in the day when your music collection mattered. Meant something. Yeah. When we got this.
Your collection meant something.
Yep. And people were like,
you've got all those songs.
I mean, that and John Parr's.
Naughty Naughty?
Naughty Naughty. Those were the two songs that, John Parr had a few other songs, so this isn't. But these two tracks were tough to find. And when we found them on CD, people were like, oh my gosh, you got that.
I don't know the Slade Come On Feel the Noise is a huge hit in the States. If it was, it was before my time. Quiet Riot had a hit with it. I know it was huge in England. And it might have done some album radio play, but I don't believe it was a hit in America. I mean, if I'm wrong, slap me in face. Slap my grandma.
Slap my grandma.
As you country folks say.
Oh, let's see. Georgia Satellites.
Slade was a Quiet Riot cover band. No! No, they were not. Slade was way before Quiet Riot.
Okay, so there's actually a couple of songs from, there's three at least that I can think of. Keep Your Hands to Yourself is the most common.
Satellite.
And yeah. That one still does work on your dance floors today, if you've got that, yes, that crowd. Hippie Shake actually worked if you had more of that 50s crowd. It came from the Cocktail soundtrack. And then the other one that came off the same album as Keep Your Hands to Yourself was Battleship Chains. The cover bands in our area played this song, Battleship Chains. Yeah, the cover bands did that one. They would, instead of playing like the number one track, they went to the, you know, the second song from the album. And that's what.
You know, the one that nobody has mentioned, and it's really one that I enjoy a lot, and I actually saw it on a Skynet. Sky TV, is that what they call it over in England? They got Sky, it's like their cable company. Anyway, it was one of their series called Curfew. The song that rolled in the ending credits was Gary Numan's Cars. And nobody's mentioned that because that was a one-hit wonder.
That was.
I mean, he had other songs, but that was his hit.
I just have never gotten into this song.
What?
Yeah.
This song is amazing.
Said the guy who's had his elbows up, you know, up to his elbows in a Ford Mustang all summer. Yeah. Okay. So let's continue on. Go-Go's. Let's deal with Go-Go's because this is
Go-Go's is not a one hit.
There's a lot here. So Vacation.
Our Lips Are Sealed. We Got the Beat. Jesus. Where was I going? Head Over Heels. Vacation.
Vacation. Here we go.
Get Up and Go. There were tons of songs from the Go-Go's.
Yeah, We Got the Beat. There's that. Our Lips Are Sealed, which is probably my favorite. My favorite
is Head Over Heels.
And yeah, Our Lips Are Sealed is my favorite.
Oh, Head Over Heels is my jam.
It's actually really, if you get their greatest hits album, it is a very good album.
It's an excellent album.
Yeah, they've got some good stuff there. And there's, again, we got the beat, Crowd Known, Our Lips Are Sealed. If you want to be cool like I am, you can play that once in a while.
Leo Sayer was not a one-hit wonder. Leo Sayer had More Than I Can Say, You Make Me Feel Like Dancing, and a slew of others. Pop Music M, I give you that one. That's a one-hit wonder. And someone earlier had mentioned Mars, Pump Up the Volume. Mm-hmm. Yes. That was actually two acts that hated each other. They got together for one track, and that was it. So they're a one-hit wonder for sure. Whoever put pop music out there, it was a lot to look at. The Fat Boys did not have one hit. They had a lot of hits.
Fat Boys?
Yeah.
Fat Boys had...
on the R&B chart. All You Can Eat.
The one that probably, I didn't see which one did they.
Well, he's putting out Fat Boys Wipeout. I don't remember Fat Boys Wipeout, but I remember Fat Boys doing the Twist with Chubby Checker. Mm-hmm. That I remember.
Yep, they did that one also.
Oh, they did Wipeout too. I remember that too. Yeah. But they also did the one with Chubby Checker and the Fat Boys doing the Twist. I remember that.
Yep, this is with the Beach Boys here.
Wipe It Out. Yeah, I remember now.
Yeah.
I had forgotten all about it. Thank you very much. Now it's stuck.
Well, we'll just play some more. So that agree to that one. And we'll end this with a song from ABBA, which if you have watched Mamma Mia, it becomes your worst.
Not a one hit.
No, but well.
The opposite of a one hit one.
Yeah, that's pretty much it. Blind Melon.
No Rain. Yeah. Kind of a special little song.
It was my first experience meeting a goth person. This would have been before I knew what goth stuff was. There was a gal that was into this in a bar, and she was all, yeah, it was kind of creepy. Wow. And scary. For me, coming from Mayberry, you know, I just, you know, went down and got my hair cut there from Floyd, and then I went out, and then DJing, and then this came. Oh, I was kind of
it said, "Hey Andy," and then you went,
"Hey Andy, check this out." Dang, Otis Goober, is up there at Goober the bar.
Filled up your tank for your left town.
She was, yeah. Joe wants to take his clothes off.
Jermaine Stewart. We don't have to take our clothes off. And Jermaine Stewart had another hit called Say It Again off of that album. And I can't remember the name of the album off the top of my head. But Jermaine Stewart was also in Shalimar when they did like their giveaway.
So Lisa, I'm that shows you guys where I'm at. I'm now like I'm in the first third of.
Okay, Lisa.
Yeah, Lisa and Cult Jam. So we have to.
There were tons of Lisa songs.
Yeah, because there's
Head to Toe. You feel the beat?
Lost in Emotion.
Lost in Emotion. Yeah.
All Cried tons. Out.
Yes.
Yeah, Can You Feel the Beat?
Mm-hmm. A lot of freestyle jams.
Yeah. A lot of good stuff there.
A lot of, like, Sly Fox, Let's Go All the Way. Yeah, that was one hit wonder.
Sixpence, None the Richer.
Kiss Me, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that was...
I don't know if they had it. I'm kind of curious about that. So Kiss Me. Oh, yeah, they did. They did have a second one.
Called what?
There She Goes. So Kiss Me, and... Yeah, actually, of the two songs, I like There She Goes better for. This is...
There She Goes. Yeah, that was. It was a remake of...
Yeah, that's a cocktail.
An Elvis Costello song or something?
Yeah, that's a cocktail tune right there for me. Life is a Rock. I'm going to play that one because I have no idea what that is.
Yes, that is One Hit Wonder.
Life is a Rock. From
the, like, mid-70s.
Yeah, it came off the 70s.
The first rap song I can think of. Okay. Just leave it roll and get to the chorus and tell me if that's a rap or what.
Okay, let's hear this. We're going to be
getting to it. Crank it up.
I guess this would be a wrap.
Eminem, 1974 right here, dude.
Yeah.
He rhymes and everything. Yeah.
Yeah. Wow.
He's going through all these pop culture references. It's a neat song. I remember trying to, being a little kid, like maybe 3-4 years old, and trying to say everything he was saying. And, you know, it's every pop culture reference you can think of. Coca-Cola, Campbell's Soup, and, you know, all kinds of stuff. I don't know.
Let's see. The Out There Brothers. I want to try to find a version. Well, I don't know. I don't.
Oh, they, boom, boom, boom. Let me tell you. Well.
Yeah, that's about the.
They had one called Whoop That, you know.
Yeah.
Yeah, that wasn't really a hit.
Yeah, I mean, I can.
It seemed like they had Boom Boom Boom. There was another one they did. What was? Oh, I can't remember. But it was kind of that stuff.
Yeah, Eddie Murphy.
Party All the Time.
Mm-hmm.
He also had one called How Can It Be?
Oh,
and he also did
that.
A song with Michael Jackson called What's Up with You. I remember those.
No, see, I don't remember any. Cheap Trick.
Venus, Shocking Blue. I'll give that one to you.
Cheap Trick, who was just at the Minnesota State Fair on Monday
not
night.
Not a one-hit wonder.
Last night. The one that Howie is referring to.
What?
The live version of I Want You to Want Me. And
yeah, but they had tons of hits, man.
Surrender.
Surrender, Dream Police.
The Flame is great.
What was the, they even had hits in the 90s. The Flame was their song, and they did a remake of Don't Be Cruel.
Yep.
They had a lot of songs. Lots.
Yeah, they did a couple of remakes there.
But they had a lot of their, like, Surrender and I Want You to Want Me and Dream Police, and there's so many.
Yeah.
I mean, that was, like, stuff that I heard on repeat when I lived in California. That Live at Budokan album, we just listened to it over and over and over again.
Electric Avenue from Eddie Grant.
Yeah. He had, I don't know if it was a hit, but I think in England he had more than one hit. But in America, he was the guy who they commissioned to do the Romancing the Stone title track for the soundtrack.
Ooh.
And Weird Al Yankovic did a version of it called I'm Not Answering the Phone for the Romancing the Stone. I remember that.
Okay, now I got to check that out.
Bismarck Key, Just a Friend. Somebody had mentioned Baha Men, Who Let the Dogs Out. In America, yeah.
Yeah, but that was
when I was in Australia. They actually put out they had a hit there with the track called You All Dat, D-A-T. And it had kind of that The Lion Sleeps Tonight thing going on in it. There's a version of that song that was on the album, and it's kind of a slow tempoed song, but there's actually a dance mix of that song that was the hit when I was in Australia. That's fantastic. I really like the song. Not the one you're seeing on the album. It's some kind of special dance mix. It's on YouTube. I found it, but it's a radio edit, but it's a dance version of it. And it's actually a really solid track. It's like where somebody remixed the song and took a crappy song and made it really good. It made it. So,
Let's see. Okay, I just was checking.
Snap the Power. Snap had more than one. Didn't Snap do rhythm as a dancer?
Yep. They did that. I wanted to do the Sugar Ray thing. So they mentioned, I think, Fly.
Someday.
And then Every Morning. And then Someday. And then When It's Over.
I like that one. Yeah, When It's Over. That's right. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Wasn't there kind of a humorous video to that one?
Yep. I think that was it. And then they had one more. They did Sugar Ray. They did, was it Jeopardy?
Bad Boys did Make You Sweat, too, and that was pretty. Or Inner Circle did Make You Sweat, or Sweat.
Sweat.
Girl, I'm going to make you sweat. Along.
There was one more that Sugar Ray did. Abracadabra was it.
Oh.
And they did a really good version of it.
Reggie says, Kim Mitchell, go for a soda. I think Kim Mitchell actually had some hits in Canada. But that might have been a minor hit in America. Disco Duck, Rick Dees. Yep, you got it. Somebody mentioned the Eiffel 65 with Blue before.
Let's see, Human League. Somebody, I'm just waiting.
Oh, no. They were not a one-hit wonder.
Don't You Want Me? Was their big hit? Me,
Mirror Man, Keep Feeling Fascination, Human, Lebanon, Love Action. There were tons of Human League songs.
Yeah, and Keep Feeling Fascination.
That's my jam.
That would be, yeah.
But I like Mirror Man, too. You never hear Mirror Man. I love that track. And it was a hit.
That's a good tune.
Yeah, it's just the song just sounds like they recorded it in somebody's bedroom or something. That's what I really like about it. It's just raw.
Oh, Midnight Oil.
Quintessentially British. Midnight Oil was a monster in Australia, but Beds Are Burning is all we got. But they were a major act in Australia. They were like, had several albums and such.
Closing Time.
And I never cared for this song.
Yeah, it was there.
The bald guy reminded me of the bald guy in The Hills Have Eyes, and I just couldn't, I can't dance to it, I don't really want to drive to it, I have no use for it.
I want to go this direction, because there was another rock on, David Essex is the one I was thinking
of. Yes, David Essex did it.
Yeah, and that's
and,
one.
And Michael Damian did it. For the soundtrack for Dream a Little Dream with Corey Feldman.
Yeah, the David Essex.
Who was pretending to be Michael Jackson for a while for some reason. I don't know why.
Pat Benatar.
Pat Benatar had a lot of hits. Off her first album, she had a lot of hits.
Mm-hmm. And we're going to go to this
Hit Me With Your Pet Shark was her big one.
We Belong.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. We. And then Love is a Battlefield. Which one did they have there? Hit Me With Your Pet Shark. Okay, and then you go to Heartbreaker.
Oh, Heartbreaker was good.
Shadows of the Night was probably one of my favorites.
Yes, that's a good one too. Yeah, loads of Pet Benatar tracks.
And then Promises in the Dark.
Dark, yes. That whole Crimes of Passion album was just amazing.
Hell is for Children, Invincible.
Hell is for Children, yeah.
And then,
I don't know if it was a hit, but it was the song we liked.
And then eventually we get to Hit Me With Your Best Shot.
Hit Me With Your Pet Shark, yeah.
Yeah, Hit Me With Your, and that's...
Dear Commissar, After the Fire. Yeah. If you're going with the After the Fire version, it's a one-hit wonder. If you're going with the Falco version, that is not a one-hit wonder because Falco had multiple hits. With Rock Me Amadeus and Vienna Calling and all kinds of songs that Austrians and Germans tell you about that we've never heard. But I like the After the Fire version is the one I'm really familiar with, and I like it a lot. And for a while, I was convinced that the guy from Pixies Midnight Runners was singing that, because it sounds a lot like him.
Very much so, huh?
But I will tell you that since then, I've discovered Falco's German version of Der Kommissar, and it's just a treat, and I love it. And if you want to do yourself a favor, go on YouTube, look up Falco, Der Kommissar, watch the music video. And if it doesn't make you laugh or smile or something, you've
you're
got a problem.
You're dead inside. You're dead inside.
A lot of fun.
Deep Blue Something, Breakfast at Tiffany's.
Yes.
Definitely a one-hit wonder.
Yes.
Goodness gracious, the volume just went really far down.
Believe Cher? No. Cher had hits for
four
decades.
That's not even, that wouldn't even be
France
fair.
Thieves Take Me Home.
Under the Church, that one I'm not familiar with. I don't.
Yeah, okay, that was one. Okay, Major Tom, Peter Schilling. Peter Schilling had a hit with that in 1983 in America. I'm sure Peter Schilling had more hits in Germany, but yes, that was a one-hit wonder in America.
Oh yeah,
Cry Little Sister. Yeah, but no, Lenny Kravitz is not a one-hit wonder. Luigi. Will Smith was not a one-hit wonder. The Lost Boys soundtrack. Oh, Jay, are you talking about the song that we heard? Yeah, I don't remember who did Cry Little Sister. It's going to really make me feel stupid because it's going to, like, you know, hit me in the face here in a minute. But yeah, that was on the Lost Boys soundtrack. But the song on the Lost Boys soundtrack you got to look out for is Eddie Barnes and INXS doing Good Times. That is the song on that soundtrack. And it doesn't get any attention anymore. Everybody forgot about it.
Mm-hmm.
And they listened to it like, oh yeah, that. I mean, Eddie Barnes is one of those guys who's like Elvis Presley in Australia.
That was the... Yeah, this is a good tune. Back when our music libraries mattered, we had this.
Yeah.
And we played that. And people were like, oh, that's such a good idea. Let's see.
Oh, Scott, send me that. Well, no, I have my own. I forgot. I was in Germany and I found a copy of. No, I wasn't. I was in Los Angeles and I found Dear Commissar. A picture sleeve of it and everything.
Sheriff, I think. Oh, didn't Sheriff have more than one song?
I think I found it in Temecula, California, as a matter of fact, at Old Town Records.
No, maybe.
Gay Stomping Ground.
I thought Sheriff had two songs, but I'm seeing only.
I don't remember two. What is Love Hadaway? Hadaway had another one, and I don't remember the name of it. Hadaway had a follow up. There was a follow up Hadaway song.
Let's see if we can find it quick.
What is Love is definitely the standout.
The first page of Hadaway is all versions of What is Love. I guess if you know, you go where your money is being made, huh?
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, I didn't know that. Who did that track check?
Paid Johnny.
Biz Markie was in the Get Fresh crew, and then he did his own thing with. I don't remember.
Johnny Kemp.
Johnny Kemp just got paid. That might have been a one-hit wonder.
Rock Lobster.
Johnny Kemp song.
Yeah, Rock Lobster was not the biggest one. Obviously, Haywire's. Yeah, knows Peter Mary.
Level 42 is not a one-hit wonder. Level 42 had at least two hits in America.
Yeah,
with Lessons in Love and Something About You, but they were major back home in England. They had several years of songs. So no, that does not qualify.
This is Lessons in Love, for those of you. And then, of course, the one that we most...
I used to know this... Oh, God. I used to know this girl who was really pretty, and she was in college, and I would go back to her dorm at night, and we would listen to Level 42's Level Best. It was the greatest hits. And I wasn't familiar with any of the other songs, but I learned all those other songs. Hanging out with this girl in her dorm, back in the, I guess, early 90s. And then I went out and I bought the Level Best too, and I learned all those tracks that were kind of like England only or something. Oh, a lot of good songs.
Let's see, Billy Vera. At this moment. What
did you think? Yeah. Probably.
Yeah, I don't think there's anything that really comes out. Good tune. Run Runaway, that was the Slade.
Mm-hmm.
That means I'm that far behind.
Yeah. Move Your Feet, Junior Senior. They actually had I don't think that was ever a hit in America, but it was a hit. But I know Junior Senior had another hit with a song called Rhythm Bandits. It was a follow-up to Move Your Feet.
Fountains of Wayne.
I kept it PG. J. And it would have been PG anyway. It would have been PG anyway. That was a girlfriend of mine who had a girlfriend of her own. So we would just hang out and drink and smoke and talk music. She was just a friend. Don't Worry, Be Happy, Bobby McFerrin. Didn't Bobby McFerrin have another song?
I don't know.
I don't know.
Let's Afro find out. Man, well, he has a high. Bobby McFerrin Essentials out there, so that's something. Yeah, I'm not seeing pretty much anything beyond this. Okay. Pop music.
Break My Stride, Matthew Wilder. I like that submission. That's a good one-hit wonder right there. Hello. From Cool Hand Scott 68. I enjoy that song.
Teach me how to Dougie. Yeah, you get into more of the newer rap stuff. There's a lot of one and done.
Yeah, they're there.
A lot of their Big Country. Yeah, we talked about that.
Yeah, Morrow. Morrow says that Eddie Murphy boogie in your butt. But there's a funny story about that. I found that record when we were crate digging. Where were we, Morrow? Were we in like Upland or something? And I got so excited, and Morrow was like, "Nope, it's mine. I've been looking for that record for years." And I'm like, no, dude, it's really important to me that I have this record. I had to give up Boogie in Your Butt Tomorrow because he'd never seen the 12-inch before. So now Morrow has it. And he said that he put it in his will that I'll get that record back when he dies.
So Sir Mix-a-Lot has at least two that have made
me. Put Them on the Glass was the song.
Yeah, Mix-a-Lot. Of course, we play.
And he did Apache.
Yeah, he did. Yep, he did Apache or a.
No, he's not
Jump
a
on
Wonder.
It, but yeah.
Jump on it or whatever.
Yeah, that's what he called his version. House of
Pain. No, we did not find that in Temecula. That was like an Upland. We were in the foothills when we found that one. That was at that one really weird place where we had to go drive in the back, and it was like a warehouse or something. And Temecula wasn't at Old Town Records. It was there. It was really weird place. Andrea True Connection, More and More and More. No, Andrea True actually had another disco hit called New York You Keep Me Dancing, and it's a great song. If you've never heard it, you got to give it listen. It's a really, really good song.
Give it again.
Was the song I'm talking about?
Yeah. What song?
Well, Jimmy's talking about More and More and More by Andrea True Connection. But she had another hit called New York You Got Me Dancing, which is a better song than More and More. And it was a club hit.
Andrea True.
It was really good.
This is what he was after.
That's More and More and More. Yeah.
Okay, so
that sounds live.
What was the other song now?
Andrea True Connection, New York You Got Me Dancing.
Right here.
Yes. Oh, but that's a bad version of it. What are you playing? It's awful.
Okay.
Don't they got like a. There we go.
Huh.
Yeah. Curly Shuffle, Jump in the Saddle. Yep, that was a one-hit wonder for sure. What was the other one? I don't know if this guy only had one hit or not, but it always reminded me of Curly Shuffle. The guy's name was John Anderson. The song was called Swingin'. Did he have any other songs?
Yes, he did, but the only one that really had nothing were big hits. Seminole Wind was probably his. If you were country, you would know this one. Seminole Wind.
Yeah.
And then Straight Tequila Night. And then Money in the Bank were the three that I could think of right off the top of my head. If you were
Starland Vocal Band, Afternoon Delight. Yep, I'll give that one to you.
Ready for the World.
Oh, Sheila.
Oh, yep. Yeah, we got to do that one just because.
Oh, Shizzle.
Kind of fits into that whole
Motown trying to sound Minneapolis
feel. Yeah, let's just go that way.
It's Motown,
but they're sounding Minneapolis. Let's see. So we did that one. Come on, scroll.
Sugar the Archies. Yeah, I think you're right. That probably is a one hit wonder.
We're gonna do the King Harvest one because, well,
oh, Dancing in the Moonlight.
Yeah, because I like that song, so we get to do this one. This is one that I have in a dinner set, and I have this one towards the time when people are getting to the point where they could hear it, actually, because people are like, this is such a great song. I forgot all about it. Okay. Let's see. Into the Night. That one
Oh, my gosh. Feelings Morris Albert. I forgot all about this song.
Where is that? Oh, we don't have it.
Putting on the Ritz by Taco. Holy shit. Yeah, that was a one-hit wonder. And probably one of the weirdest songs of the 1980s. I can't think of a weirder song.
Benny.
That's terrible. It's about a pedophile. And my mom likes it. Every time it comes on like Yacht Rock Radio on XM, and she gets down, and I'm like, Mom, this song's like really slimy. Let's skip it. She thinks it's a good tune. Well, I don't care what they're saying. I just think it's a jam.
I just like the song. Let's see.
Yeah, let's all chant. I think that yeah.
Oh, let's go to Soup Dragons.
I'm Free. Yeah.
Yeah, there's a couple. They've got a couple of songs that.
That came out right around the same time Love and Rockets was still alive came out.
This is I'm Free. And then they had, which one did they say? Divine Thing, yep.
Oh, I beg you to remember that. Yes.
It's a good tune.
You were an angel.
Mr. Mortimer gets a silver star for the day.
How Long by Ace.
Come on.
I have a story about that song.
Let's see.
That I believe that was a one-hit wonder.
Covers don't count.
So, if you're familiar with the song How Long by Ace, it sounds like a breakup song, but it's actually not. It's a song about the bass player of the band went ahead and snuck out an audition for another band, and the lead singer found out about this and wrote the song about the bass player possibly leaving the band. So it's not really a boy-girl breakup song. It's a bass player leaving the band song.
Oh, yeah. We were going to do the...
Yeah, Vehicle, Ice of March. That would definitely count. You guys are Googling this stuff. You're not that good. You can see I'm not Googling anything, and I'm rattling this off the top of my head. You guys are trying to make me look bad. You can't do it. Got you. Oh, Taco.
Yeah, had
God, that guy was weird, man.
It was.
It was like electronic 30s or something. Yeah. I think he was really into it, but nobody else was.
There's the level 42.
It was like a movement.
She Blinded Me with Science.
Johnny Taylor was not a one-hit wonder, Jay. Johnny Taylor, the disco lady, man. Moving in, moving out. Moving in, rubbing out. School-dated. For Brian and John, hey, now let's get down. Let's all go to Allentown. Yep. We're gonna talk about that.
Alias, More Than Words Can Say, because somebody throwing that out there.
What, Leo Sayer?
No, Alias. More Than Words Can Say.
Oh,
sorry.
Me and Mrs. Jones, Billy Paul. I'm sure it probably was a one.
John might get through the list by 9 o'clock Pacific. Yeah, I only got another hour to go.
Oh, you're just seeing that?
Yes, that shows you how far back up I am. Actually, I'm kind of scooting now because some of these you've already talked about. And
well, I'm trying to hit them all as they Baltimore. Go, but I mean, I missed some of them because I'm trying to like pause so you can say things. Steelers wheel stuck in the middle with you in America. Yeah. But I mean, Jerry Rafferty went on to have a couple of hits anyway, here in the States with Baker Street and Right Down the Line and Get It Right Next Time. Tim Curry, I Do the Rock. Oh, wow. You're getting weird on me, Dave. I mean, we don't count Sweet Transvestite from the Rocky Horror soundtrack or Wild and Untamed Thing or any of that weird stuff.
It didn't even... If there was the lowest level of popularity on iTunes, this has it. I don't know if that would be considered anything.
Yeah, it's pretty bad.
Yeah.
No, John Cafferty had another track. And I think it was, yeah, was it Tender Years? Was their follow-up hit?
John
Cafferty and the Beaver Brown Band. On the Dark Side.
Yeah,
and then the other one was I think it was called Tender Years.
On the Dark Side? Follow-up. Tender Years is here.
Yeah, that was their follow-up. Informer, no, Informer had another track called Girl, I've Been Hurt. That was his follow-up. So Snow is not a one-hit wonder, even in the U.S. Did Debbie Gibson have any big hits? Yes, she did. Debbie Gibson had slews of hits. Level is Only in My Dreams, Shake Your Love, Foolish Beats, Electric Youth. There were a lot of Debbie Gibson songs.
Lost in Your Eyes, Only in My Dreams, Electric Youth. So Only in My Dreams and Shake Your Love were the
tops.
Yeah.
Probably.
Foolish Beat. I believe she had like somewhere between eight and 10
the
songs.
The Crickets in John's place, not mine.
Yeah, the Crickets, he just started over here. I don't know how he got in here, but yeah, sorry about that. But
yeah, Robert Miles, he's died. It was last year, Robert Miles died.
The Cricket decided to come out and play. Seems like about a half an hour you were talking about Curly Shovel.
Up in the saddle.
Yeah.
A little behind there, John. Yeah. No, man. You guys were a lot of fun tonight throwing out those songs for us and trying to keep us on our toes. Don't forget to like the damn video, guys. Go like the video. You're here. Just go hit the like button because we like you. You should like us too. Like us back.
This is another song that can be tossed in. Archie's Sugar.
Somebody mentioned that in the chat.
Yeah, they did. I've got there. I'm kind of scrolling a little quicker now.
Yeah.
Brandy's Looking Glass. Well, I've got to play that one because.
Yeah, that's the one hit wonder. As is Come and Get Your Love by Redbone. And
yeah, pretty much anything on the Guardians of the Galaxy.
A lot of them, yeah.
A lot of them. Not the yellow stuff, but almost everything down there.
Lakeshore Drive is a one-hit wonder. Pac-Man Fever, Buckner and Garcia.
Man, that would be awesome.
Was it a hit? I mean, I remember the album and everybody bought it. Was it a hit? Hey There, Delilah, Plain White Tees, probably.
No, that's not the song I was looking for.
Redbone had three hits. Well, Redbone didn't tell anybody else about the other two. Google's lying to you, Joe.
Yeah, get out of Google, man.
It's good. It's reliable.
Yeah, there. Okay, so Brian's can see the current. There he is there. Okay, I zipped through to get to the end.
Okay.
Oh, man. So, there we are.
Yeah, Black Betty. Yeah, Funky Town Lives Incorporated. Yep, I'll give you that one.
There's a lot of good tracks out there.
I think Born to Be Alive by Patrick Hernandez, not Joe Hernandez. Joe Hernandez.
You know,
Patrick Hernandez.
His cousin sang a version. That's what Jimmy's after.
Yeah, had a hit with it, too.
Yeah, it was amazing. It was a family thing. They get together and they'd sing the song.
Pat and Joe.
Yeah, they just had a great old.
Yeah, The Vinyls, I Touched Myself. I believe the Vinyls actually had several hits in Australia. But I Touched Myself was the only one they had over here that I'm aware of.
I'm going to skip ahead. Boardwalk Angel. Joe mentioned, or no, somebody mentioned to look up.
Jam on it, Nucleus. Yeah, I'm thinking that's probably
one.
I don't think they did. Yeah.
Okay.
I don't even think that was a hit. Maybe it was. I don't remember. Wow, man. They're throwing them at us. So,
and
yeah.
There's our hour. We've got our hour here.
Holy crap. A lot of songs.
A lot of stuff we've covered tonight. So for those of you who have never heard some of these songs, hopefully you were able to get a little bit, and hopefully we aren't being blocked on. I should check and see if
I don't think so.
I'm going to check and see if my Facebook account is still up.
This really is like incidental fair use stuff. I've seen stuff a lot more blatant than what you're doing. You're playing clips.
We were having fun with that. So
I was having fun actually today earlier on Mara Luna's Facebook page. She was asking people to post instrumental songs.
Oh, yeah.
So we were doing lists of those. I was sparring with Scott Favor, and he was doing really good. So.
Oh, yeah, Scott.
Pulled up some real weirdos, you know.
Yeah, it's fun. Scott knows his stuff. He's very knowledgeable. So.
Oh, yeah.
Well, gang, we're going to wrap things up. We'll get back in next week. We'll talk weddings and such. Before we go though, coming up November, the first week of November, I want to give you the URL so you guys can go out and check this out. And it's not on that page. It's on this page. You guys can go out and find out what Brian and I are going to be doing November 3rd and 4th out at themobiledjmeetup.com. Themobiledjmeetup.com. Out there, it'll take you to the Facebook event page, and then you can find out what's more information. There is going to be a DJ educational event going on in Allentown.
Networking event.
Yeah, we're going to basically be going there and hanging out and sharing a little information, learning some things from you guys, talking about talking shop and having some good eats and such. It's going to be a great event. There's some, Brian and I are there.
I actually consulted on this one. And nice. The reason I bring that up is because I kind of told the organizers what I liked about shows and what I didn't like about shows. So I told them, hey, let's just try this for fun. The things that I like about shows, let's make it happen. Like, let's get the right people there. Let's not just, open this up to 5,000 people. Let's limit this. Let's get a limited number of people, get the right people in the door. And when it comes to vendors, let's not have a real loud room and some really huge booths. And you walk around, it's like, well, who the hell is this guy? I want to know who every vendor there is. And I want to know them personally by name, have one-on-one conversations with them, learn about their products if I'm interested, or just talk shop with them if I'm not. But, more of a networking thing than a preachy thing or buy my book kind of thing,
Yeah, for sure.
Your ego's at the door. Come on in, have a good time. Talk to your peers. Maybe you learn something. Unfortunately, you're going to have to listen to me ramble for about an hour because I'm the keynote at this event. But and John, too. But
yeah,
other than that, it's just kind of hang, enjoy.
It'll be a fun 2 days. Again, the MobileDJMeetup.com. Go out there and check it out. There's a few tickets left for sale. Next Tuesday, actually, Owen's going to be jumping on our show with us to kind of talk a little bit about the whole process and such, because he's putting it together. So we'll have a special guest with us next Tuesday night. So for those of you out there, thank you much for being with us tonight. We'll be back next Tuesday. Actually, next week, we're going to be starting with the whole gamut of shows. We're going to have multiple shows going on Monday, Tuesdays, and Wednesdays starting next week again. So we'll see you then. Have a good night, everybody.